Hello to everyone. I am Dr. P. Ganesh Kumar from the Department of Information Technology, Anna University Regional Campus, Coimbatore. In this semester, I am going to teach you the subject data structures. Basically, the content of my teaching is focused by the syllabus for the third semester BE Computer Science and Engineering students, especially 2017 regulation. The subject code is CS839. Before getting into the subject data structure, my lecture here is planned in such a way that first of all, you should understand what purpose you should study data structure and what is mean by data structure and how the data structure is classified. And finally, I will give you some overview about the various units of this subject data structure. To begin with, data structure, why is it so important for the computer science and engineering student? You know that nowadays in the modern world, computers are present everywhere. In every field, you could find the computers, or you could find the people using computers. That means without computers, nowadays no job is carried out. Do you know the original purpose for inventing this device, that is the computer, is to carry out mathematical computation? Why? Because is the scientist need a device that perform mathematical computation much faster, even sometimes very faster than human being. So they invented a machine and they called by the name computers. Slowly, as the requirements or the need or the necessity, whatever it may be, based on the requirement, slowly the computer usage will turn into not only in terms of computing some mathematical problems, but also in a position to solve some real world problems, some real world problems. So the usage of computers is turned from simple mathematical computation to a problem solving machine. To solve any problem using computer, of course, you all well know that what is mainly required? Yes, it is nothing but algorithm. So to solve any problem using computer, we need algorithm. What is an algorithm? An algorithm is a well-defined steps so that each and every step should be properly followed to arrive solution to the problem. Once the algorithm is framed, then each step of the algorithm can be converted into a set of executable statements, and those bunch of executable statements is collectively called by the name program. And this program can be developed using any programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, and so on. Now, any user of a computer, when he is going to use a computer for solving a problem or to find a solution for a problem, definitely he needs to devise an algorithm, and from the algorithm he needs to construct a program, and that program is implemented successfully to derive the solution. If he or she did so, then he is called by the name programmer. That is, one who solves a problem using computer by creating programs for the problem is going to be called a programmer. Here, my question is, who is an efficient programmer? Of course, anyone who knows C, C++, Fortran, Java, Python, and whatever it may be, can do simple programs using computer. Once upon a time, he may be a an expert in writing programs for the problems given to him or her. But there are certain situations we may call those as a efficient programmer, not simply a programmer. In what aspects we may call them as a programmer? Let's see, or let's discuss in these subjects. What a program does, that means what a computer program does, a computer program always needs some data to be fed as input to the program. Once some input has been fed, then the duty of the program or the statements that is written in the program is to compute the data, that is process the data to produce a solution. That is, in simpler form, it can be said that it accepts the data, process the data, and then it produces the output. So here, to solve any problem, what mainly required data is required. Here, one thing you need to remember. Whatever may be the complexity of the problem, whether the problem is problem complexity is 0 to infinity, that means very simpler problem to very higher complex problems, what is mainly required? Data is required. So in order to say a programmer as an efficient programmer, if and only if the data is organized in a proper manner. Let us consider an example to illustrate this issue. I am calling a student. Hi Ashok, come. Go to my table and take a book in data structure. The student go to my table and see in my table. In my table, many books are organized. Many books are there, not organized, many books are there. But they are not in a proper manner. They are in some random order or random arrangements or order in me. So, in order to trace the book that I told him to find out, he has to search the book one by one, and he has to take the book that I have asked him, and then he has to come back to my classroom and hand out the book. Now if I ask the question, how long you take for taking the book? Did you straight away go to my room, or you search for a room, or you go to somewhere and go and search the book? What might be the answer from the student? No sir, I go to your room, I search for the books in the table. Since the books are not in a proper arrangements, I search each and every book. It takes some time to find out the book. Hence the delay. That's the answer given by the student. Okay. Next day, I think about the process. Now, what I did is, I arranged all the books one by one by making the name of the book as a visibility one for the one who was interested to take the book. In such a way, I organized the book. Next time, next day, when I go to the class, I call the same student. I go ask the student to go and take that book. Now, the student is with hesitation came to my room and searched for the books. Fortunately, he is able to find out my book very easily and come to my classroom in a very lesser time. Now I ask the question to the same student. Now yesterday you take longer time, now you are taking very lesser time. Why? The answer sent by the student says, no sir, yesterday when I go to your table, all the books are not in a proper arrangement, they are in a jumbled order. One book is in that side, one book is in that side, one book is above the other book, one book is in opened manner, one book is in the closed manner, one book is in downside, but like that. So I search each and every book, I open the book and look at the title, I close the book, I open the book, look at that. Like that, I made many tasks to identify the book that you are asked for. But today, fortunately, I could see that all the books are arranged in a proper manner. So I need very lesser time to find out the book that you have asked for, and I take the book and I come to your classroom to hand over it. So that's the reason, sir. Dear students, I hope that you understand the answer. So here you correlate the fact that books are nothing but data, the table is nothing but the space allotted or the memory for the computer. If the books are in a random order or random arrangements, my complete table is full of books. It seems to be full of books. But if I arrange the books in one particular corner of the table or in my any place of the table, then quite naturally it will occupy very smaller space. Of course, the table is, the book is very visible to the person who is interested to take the books, and it needs very lesser time, because searching is very easier for the one who takes the book if it is arranged in a proper manner. In the same way, whenever a programmer is going to write a program, he is going to use the computer memory, no doubt in it. But first, he needs to access the data. Before computing the data, that is before processing the data, a programmer should choose a proper arrangements for the data. If the data is arranged properly, then the computation of the data, that is processing over the data, is very easier. That means it takes very lesser time. So now I hope that you understand the need for data structure. Yes, data structure is nothing but the way of organizing the data in the computer memory before processing it, so that it will always helpful to write a program that is efficient in terms of time as well as in terms of memory. So as a computer science engineering students, whenever you want to say that you are an efficient programmer, you should always know about the subject data structure. Hence, it is a must for every computer science and engineering students, or those who are interested to do programs with the help of computers. Now, what is data structure? It is the study that deals with methods, techniques, and tools for what? To organize the data. Why to organize the data? To consume less memory and less time. What benefit we got out of it? When the program consumes less memory and less time, the algorithm is efficient and the implementation of the program is also efficient. So what is data structure? Data structure is the study of methods, techniques, tools to organize the data so that the program always consumes less memory and less time. This data structure is in general is classified into two categories. One is linear data structure, another one is non-linear data structure. Under linear category, you have list, stack, and queue. Under non-linear category, you have tree, graph. So this is the way in which the data structure is classified. Accordingly, your subject, that is CS8391 data structure for this semester, is organized into 5 units. The first unit deals with linear data structure, especially the list. The second unit deals with linear data structure, especially stack and queues. Third and fourth unit discusses about the non-linear data structures like trees and graph respectively. Finally, some programming design techniques have been discussed under fifth unit in the name searching, sorting, and hashing techniques. So this is the overview of the units that are given in the subject data structure for the third semester BE Computer Science and Engineering students under Anna University Chennai and in 2017 regulation. I hope you understand the need, that is why data structure and what data structure it is and how the data structure is classified and what are the units under the subject CS8391 data structure. Thank you. In the subsequent videos, we will be seeing about unit by unit and topic by topic. I hope you have understood the motive, the purpose of this particular subject. Thank you for your listening and thank you so much.